market running. Let's get your house show ready.
A little preparation goes a long way with selling your home.
The next week is going to be busy, but it's going to be worth it.
Remove all the things you can off of the walls and then patch those holes.
As far as countertops go in the kitchen, that's another big thing. You want as much space as possible and to make it look as roomy as possible. Mm-hmm. Basically, if you can eliminate almost everything off your countertops, except for your one or two favorite appliances that you have on there, that's what we recommend.
Let's have you make two extra sets of keys, one for the lockbox and one for our team. And don't forget your set of keys so you're never locked out.
Now start packing today, especially personal items. You'll be really happy that you've got half your house packed up when it's time to get to moving. And think about medications and special items. Let's get those packed if we can. Mm-hmm. We're hoping to have a lot of people through your house and we don't want anything to end up in their pockets.
As far as toys go, if you have children, try to keep their five favorite toys that they use all the time. And try to box up the others so that when a showing happens or you get a phone call for a showing, it's a lot easier to get ready for the home. Plus, when you move to your next place and your kids find those toys, it's like Christmas all over again.
That's a good point. So when you fill those boxes, the best situation is put them somewhere away from the property. If you've got a storage container or a utility trailer or an in-law you can put them at, if not, stack them neatly in the corner of the garage so they're out of the way.
Make sure to watch these six helpful staging videos that you're going to receive because we want your house to be ready to go. And we also are going to be taking pictures and doing your home movie. And that's when it should look the best. Mm-hmm. Things like your closet should be about 30% full. It makes them look bigger.
That's right.
So remember, kind of the biggest thing in selling your home isn't to spend money on preparing it, but to deep clean and to declutter. Mm-hmm. We mentioned the countertops. Again, try to have your kitchen counters as empty as possible just to show counter space. Pictures off of your fridge is nice too, just to kind of have people be able to focus on the home and not your personal items. Mm-hmm. Same with floor and space. Just do everything you can to declutter and to have it look as open and large as possible.
Let's talk about animals for a minute because most of us love animals and have pets. Mm-hmm. Some people don't. Mm-hmm. And so it's a good idea to plan ahead what you're gonna do with your animal and their things. And so let's remove the food, the beds, the toys, and let's keep a couple of things that you can put away the minute you get a phone call and have a plan where the family pet is going to go during the showing.
We've had some people, when they walk into a home and they see pets, they don't even want to look at the home.
That's right.
So let's just eliminate that. And sometimes people too, I mean, your trophy bull elk hanging or your deer, we've had people just walk out of the house instantly. Yeah. I mean, congrats on the big elk or big deer, but some people, that could turn people away.
That leads us really, the idea is when you are getting your house ready, remember, it's not about you anymore.
Right.
You're now trying to sell your house to someone else and they may not have the same taste as you.
Good point. When
we ask to remove all these items, it's because we're trying to create that clean slate. We want pictures off the walls. We want personalized things put away because even though it looks great, somebody else may not like it and we don't want them not to be interested in your house just because they didn't like your decor. Yeah.
But at the same time, you want to create the homey feel.
Right.
You want to have it be homey. You don't want to take away that. Going back to the deep clean, the bathrooms, we want people to be able to not look at things that they might have to do.
Or smell.
Or smell, yeah. And so basically we want to create this home that almost is too perfect to live in so that they can envision that home being perfect for them. And that would be deep cleaning the bathroom, the countertops, the toilets, the
especially
shower.
Especially the mirrors.
The mirrors, especially. Mm-hmm.
So then let's talk about the outside of the house. That's a part of our marketing is the street or the curb appeal, right? Mm-hmm. And so let's make sure the lawn is mowed. If it's snowing, let's shovel those walks so we don't have people falling and slipping down. And let's get the flower beds at least weeded. When they walk up to the front door, put yourself in their situation and say, is this show ready? Is this a clean house that I don't have to come in and do all the work on?
One thing too with the flower beds, mm-hmm. a lot of times they fill with weeds and people say, do I need to buy bark or spend a bunch of money? We don't want you to spend any more money than you have to. What we recommend is just go in and just till it. Just have the soil look fresh. Mm-hmm. Just make it easy. Spend some time, not money, and just make it look nice.
Yeah.
Get rid of the weeds.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. And then that when you guys are under contract, make sure you need to still keep your lawn mowed and the walks shoveled, even when you've accepted a contract.
Yeah, good.
And even
good
trimmed,
point.
If you can do that with the fence and
makes it literally good. Real estate is a beauty contest and a price war. The one thing we can really control is the beauty and how your house looks. So let's take control of that.
And a lot of that is just elbow grease and not spending money.
Right.
One thing that comes up often is the garage. And if the garage really matters in preparing your home to sell, we have one car garages, two car garages, three car garages. What you want to be able to do is make that garage look as big as possible. We've had some people buy a home thinking that their garage is bigger when really it's the same size or maybe sometimes smaller. It just is open space. There's nothing on the floor. Things are organized and it creates that perception. So do whatever you can to make sure there's nothing on the floor and anything that's on the walls or on shelves basically looks organized, and it'll go a long ways in your showing, especially if you have a two car and you're trying to compete with a three car that they're looking at.
So there are those garages that are like better than the inside of some homes, right?
Yeah. Oh yeah.
If it's that type of garage, you've got to have it looking top notch.
Yep.
Because that's a selling feature now.
Exactly. Yeah. That's a big feature. If it's a regular garage, you don't have to go in and paint the floors and clear out and reorganize everything. Just make sure it's tidy.
Yeah. Floor space is key in making it look big.
Yeah.
Good.
So you guys, if you're looking at this, hopefully these messages are helping you. Our smart messages is what we're calling them. If they are and you're enjoying this communication, who can you introduce us to that might be looking to sell their home? Because with good information,
you can make great decisions. Good decisions. And if you have any other questions, ask us. We're trying to hit the main things. You're going to have specific questions, call.
You know, I think smart messages are awesome because instead of trying to rely on contacting a human, you can know about the entire transaction from start to finish on day one. You're not waiting for something to happen and then asking, what do I do next? What do I do next? So if you have access at your fingertips all day and all night, all of our information and our experience, then you can trust that we're gonna do the right thing because you're able to understand where we're at each phase of the transaction. So these smart messages are gonna be amazing.